Yo, what's going on, guys? It's Dannyvandam, and hope you guys are having a pretty awesome day. Welcome to another Universe Mode episode. And before we get into it, I do want to make some announcements, so to say. Currently, we're champions, you know, if we go to actually one show here. But if we do go to champions, anyways, you see Nikki Bella is the women's champion on Raw. And she actually didn't get a chance to defend her title at the last pay per view, which is Extreme Rules, which was the last Universe Mode episode. And that was solely because there just wasn't enough room on the card. If we go on SmackDown, we'll see that Charlotte Flair actually defended her SmackDown Women's Championship against Asuka. And, I mean, I'm going to give you a chance to go click on that video, episode 7, I think it was. So, go click on the video and see who wins. I'm going to spoil it in a second. 3, 2, 1. Right, so Asuka is obviously the new champion. And, so, what I'm thinking about doing is because there's just not enough room for two divas divisions and two tag divisions where they both get to defend the titles evenly on pay-per-views. Otherwise, I would have to make another pay-per-view just because we don't have room for rivalries then. And I think it's just a bit of a piss take, to be honest with you. So what I'm going to do at the next pay-per-view, the women's champion from Raw and the women's champion from SmackDown will be having a match at Payback, and we will crown the new undisputed women's champion there. Now, I'm not going to reveal the belt yet, but yeah, we're going to have a new undisputed women's champion at Payback. The same thing goes for the tag team championships. The four titles will be getting put on the line, and whoever wins is obviously the new undisputed tag champions. And then we'll keep the minor titles on the shows, and then we'll keep the WWE Universal title and the World Heavyweight. And yeah, that's basically just what I want to do. So saying that Nikki Bella didn't actually get to defend her title on the pay-per-view, she's going to be defending on this Raw. And by the way, if you're wondering why there's so many matches, because Universe is trying to screw us as usual, because it said that they'll put out a patch, and it's put out a patch and it still hasn't fixed Universe Mode, which I'm really salty about, but let's not get into that. Anyways, have a look here. Tonight's card is Fandango taking on Daniel Bryan. Now, I haven't seen Daniel Bryan lately. Well, we haven't seen much of him anyways. He hasn't really made a bit of an impact. He's still just climbing the ranks as of now. So he's just going to be in a normal match against Fandango. Then we're going to have Sasha Banks versus Tamina. That should be good. Ooh, right here. So Brock Lesnar makes his in-ring debut on Raw. He has not been on our Universe yet. He makes our Universe debut, and he's cutting a promo tonight in Birmingham. And now we have Randy Orton, which is the number one contender. He is the number one contender for the Universal title at the minute, because Seth Rollins did lose at the pay-per-view. Seth Rollins does feel as if he's a bit screwed out the victory, though, because he did pin Finn Balor on the outside, yet the referee was out. And he couldn't get past the dumpster to see the pinfall, which Seth Rollins ultimately believes that he's been screwed out the championship. So we'll see where he lies. But as of now, Randy Orton is the number one contender. And then we're going to go on for Baron Corbin versus John Cena. John Cena is the United States champion, and he did beat Sheamus. Now, this will be the main event of the evening, which will be Bayley versus Nikki Bella in a championship match. And actually, I need to go edit that, so it's a championship match. But these other three matches are just added matches, because the Universe Mode just kind of wants to screw us. And when you add matches, it just kind of adds loads. So we're just going to forget about them, and that's record. So, yeah. Anyways, I'll see you when the show starts, and yeah. And here we are, Monday Night Raw, as these fireworks go off. I don't know why that kid's going to just bring a tie, to be honest with you, because he's not appearing here at night, unfortunately. Maybe down the line, maybe we'll have an appearance from Dwayne The Rock Johnson. But apart from that, what you can count on, is Snickers signs all the way around the logo on every single arena. All around the logo, what? All around the arena, every single place we go. Right, so let's load into this. We're probably only going to play about two matches, to be fair, because this takes a long time, and we'll be playing the promo anyways. So let's go ahead and simulate this match. Let's see who wins between Fandango and Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan picks up the victory against Fandango. Whatever, no one cares. Anyways, Sasha Banks versus Tamina Scrub. Woo! Tamina got the defeat over Sasha Banks. What? Okay. Alright. Let's get straight into the Brock Lesnar promo. Alright, here he is. The myth, the man, the legend, the beast, the one in 21 and one. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Brock Lesnar. I think I'll pull him in. First time he's actually grabbing a mic by himself. Let's see if he's actually not stupid enough to make a promo. I mean, anything's better than Roman Reigns, I guess. Lol. Pew, pew, pew. Shots fired. So, you all know exactly why I'm out here. So let's cut to the chase. Okay, Brock Lesnar is not wasting any time. I've been making life a living hell for everyone back in that locker room. They fear the day that they enter the ring with me because they know that there is nothing they can do to prevent the beatdown that I'm going to deliver. The nightmare comes true today for one specific superstar tonight. Oh, he's calling someone out, I think. But that's very true. No one wants to step in the ring with Brock Lesnar. The beast incarnate. And let's see where the promo goes. Finn Balor, ooh, Finn Balor, get your ass out here, we're going to have a chat, and then I'm going to, okay, I didn't, you guys can pause that, I didn't let us read all that. Here he is, he has the Universal Champ, Finn Balor. Here he is, he hasn't got his title like, but let's see what Finn Balor has to say to Brock Lesnar, calling him out. Brock Lesnar not waste any time with anyone else in the locker room, he's going straight for the champion here, as he waits for Finn Balor to come to the ring. Finn Balor looking hype. Finn Balor, maybe he's putting on a face. I think he might be fully recovered. I don't know. We're gonna have to check the news after this. Let's see if he's fully recovered from the pay-per-view. He did have a head injury, so we'll see what he has to say here. I really don't know why I'm out here at night. I was standing in the back, then something pulled me to come out here. I have no idea what it is, but now here I am, and it appears. There you are. Imagine that. Two superstars talking to each other in this very ring. But you see, Brock Lesnar doesn't like to talk, so we'll see what happens. Brock Lesnar looks as if he's squaring up. Bzz, bzz, bzz. You hear that? It's the sound of a bug, an annoying, insignificant little insect trying to make a whole lot of noise, thinking it's bigger than it actually is. The problem with bugs, when they run into actual men, is that they tend to get squashed, and it just so happens I'm a real man. Brock Lesnar, chatting a lot of trash. But I mean, everything he's saying is completely correct. He has squashed everyone he's came in his way, including the Undertaker at WrestleMania. Let's see what Finn Balor says back. Hold up, stop right there. Are you implying, maybe suggesting, you want a match with me? Please tell me that's what you want. I want to hear it. Go ahead. I'm not too sure if Finn Balor wants to be getting in the ring with Brock Lesnar, to be honest with you guys. Very dangerous man. This could be a huge mistake. This could be career ending. What is this? I'm sure that's what you love to hear, but no, I don't want any part of you. When you've earned your place with the WWE Universe, I'll humble you if that's what you want. What? But now my focus is a lot bigger target than you, so step aside and get out my way. Ah, fair enough. It looks like he doesn't want to match them, he just wants to kind of run through. Well, you would have to have a match with them to have the Universal title, so I don't know where this promo's going, to be honest with you. I'm going to ask you to stop right there because you've embarrassed yourself enough. Unless, of course, you want to back up everything you just said, in which case I'm happy to embarrass you more. What are you talking about? Brock Lesnar would squash you. We'll see. Oh? Oh, you want to fight? Now you're speaking my language. Tell you what. Why don't we do it big? Why don't we fight at the pay-per-view? Once and for all, we put everything we've got on the line for the whole world to see. Ooh, okay. So Brock Lesnar, obviously, he's a, what's it called? He used to say back in the day that he only fights for money, and that he only does at the biggest pay-per-views. So apparently he wants to fight Finn Balor, payback. We'll see what he reacts with. You know, I'm a pretty relaxed guy. Sure, I go full tilt in the ring, but most of the time I'm pretty chill. But inside my head, there's a switch. And when it flips, I can't be responsible for what I do. And brother, you just flipped that switch. Oh god, what does that mean? Does he mean he's gonna go demon form at the next pay-per-view? We don't know. Maybe he's gonna unleash the demon inside of him to take out Brock Lesnar. If this match happens, it's gonna be a hell of a match. Brock Lesnar. Ooh, Brock Lesnar with a low blow. Brock Lesnar with a low blow just taking out Finn Balor, sending a message. What is this? No, Finn Balor in a bad position. As Brock Lesnar is just starting to beat down on Finn Balor in the ring. What is this? No, Finn Balor, he's fighting back with an enziguri to the beast. An enziguri to the beast as he stands on the back of the arms of Brock Lesnar. Going up top. What is this? He's calling Brock Lesnar to his feet. What the hell is this? Oh, but look at this. The strength of Brock Lesnar. The strength of Brock Lesnar. And just taking him to Suplex City. And there with another huge clothesline just taking out the champion. Brock Lesnar, livid. Oh, and he shoves the referee out the way. And there's the stare down. So there you have it, guys. At the next pay-per-view payback, we will see Finn Balor go one-on-one with the beast Brock Lesnar for the WWE Universal Championship. Alright, so into the next match on the card. As you see here, we have the number one contender, Randy Orton, goes one-on-one with Neville, the man that gravity forgot. Now, Randy Orton, he's been climbing up the ranks slowly but surely. He's definitely the guy that you forget about, you know. He's just kind of, he's not really the guy that sits in the back of your mind, you know. He just strikes from nowhere. He just comes up when the time's right. Obviously, he used to be in a tag team with Edge, so he's learned a few things from the Ultimate Opportunist. You know, he's just been keeping his head down and grinding away just to get that number one contendership for the championship. So, you know, he's definitely been climbing up. I mean, yeah, Brock Lesnar is now the self-proclaimed number one contender, and Finn Balor says that he does want to fight him at the next pay-per-view, but that doesn't mean that the pay-per-view after that, Randy Orton can't have a shot at the title. That's if he does stay the number one contender. We're going to see what happens, though. Okay, so there's Randy Orton's entrance. Now, his opponent. Let's see if we can prove why he should be the number one contender. But here he is. The man that gravity forgot. I never thought his entrance was that long. Okay. Wow, that cape looks like shit. I'm not even gonna lie. Alright, so Neville making his way to the ring with his jobber attire. Staying hydrated. You know, because if I don't, I'm just be voice. Okay, so he's making a big run in the ring. But Randy Orton, getting straight to business. What is this? Oh my gosh, Russian leg sweep straight off the bat. The referee getting inside to start the match. Huge neck breaker on Neville in the middle of the ring. Randy Orton taking it at Neville early on in this matchup. With a huge clothesline in the corner, decapitating Neville. Randy Orton starting to show that bit of flair that he's got, you know. Oh, what is this? Snap suplex. Now Randy Orton just taking him with his feet. Ooh, but a huge jawbreaker from Neville. As he goes up, what's this? some sort of fall over DDT, nailing Randy Orton in the match. Now, if Neville can beat Randy Orton, this is going to be a huge upset. I haven't seen much of Neville in the past, like in this universe mode. But if he can beat him, this is going to be huge. You know, maybe he's looking for a minor title shot. I don't know. Or we can even push him to the main title. But I mean, I feel as if the main title is just a bit too hectic at the minute. So maybe if he gets a win on this, we'll give him a shot against John Cena's United States Championship. Not that that'll matter because it's John Cena, but still. That's Storm straight in this corner. Oh no, that's bouncing off the ropes. Another jawbreaker by Neville. And just a huge forearm. As he goes up top, maybe he's looking for that red arrow. But Randy Orton, getting to his feet. Neville doing a bit of a botch. Okay. He didn't quite hit all that. And I think Randy Orton knows that as he gets inside the ring. Maybe a bit too slow as he hits the Northern Lights suplex. Randy Orton didn't expect that, the speed of Neville. And now Randy Orton looking in a bad position. As he goes up. Oh, no, but Randy Orton finds a way to get out. And he gets him out. What's this? Some sort of powerbomb. No, neckbreaker. Another neckbreaker. Targeting the neck of Neville. Really going after the head of Neville. What is this? Oh, Randy Orton starting to slow this match down to the pace he likes. Just toying with Neville now. Look at this, just taunting him. Maybe he thinks he's not worthy. I don't know. But Neville fighting back once again. Starting to show. Oh, wait. Where is he going now? Oh, he's going to the outside. He's calling him up. He's calling Randy Orton to his feet. Oh, no. I thought Randy Orton had a reverse tap, but he didn't. Okay, Neville starting to gain some huge momentum here. By the way, guys, if you are enjoying the series, make sure you hit that subscribe button if you already haven't. Huge shooting star pressed in the middle of the ring. But no, Randy Orton goes for a move. But no, Neville, he reverses. What's this? Neville going for a snap suplex. But no, Randy Orton with another neck breaker. The third neck breaker in this match. Neville. His head must just be pounding inside. He's got to be careful for that concussion. As Neville, he turns around. What is this? What is this? Taking him to Suplex City himself as he hits him with a huge German. That could be it. That could be all if he goes for the pin right now. But no. Neville goes. Ooh, that's some sort of corkscrew moonsault. What is this? That could be all. One. Ooh, two count. That was almost three. Randy Orton managing to get the shoulder up though. Randy Orton. And another standing shooting star. Wow. The athleticism of this guy is amazing. Now Randy Orton in a bad position. A bad position. Now Neville. Maybe calling for the end as he points to the sky. As he goes to pick up Randy Orton. No, but Randy Orton. Hitting with that arm. What is this? He's getting him up in some sort of angle slam. Now, Randy Orton. What is this? He's just picking him to his feet. He throws him over. Oh no. Randy Orton could be hearing voices, people. He could be hearing voices as he just nails him with that DDT. Randy Orton going to that place. He's starting to taunt him. As he starts to get to his feet. What is this? Vintage Orton with that backbreaker. This could be all she wrote. Maybe it's Randy Orton picking him up to go for the RKO. Oh, European uppercut. No, he throws him at the corner. What is this? Oh, he's putting him up top. Maybe shades of the late great. What's his name? Cowboy Bob Orton. Just punching away. Neville at the top rope. I don't know what he was trying to achieve there. But he throws him to the outside. And what is this? Another neckbreaker to Neville. Another neckbreaker. Really targeting that head. And Randy Orton is He's someone you don't want to get in the ring with. Oh. But Neville. What's this? After another snap suplex. But once again, Randy Orton just gets out of it. And he misses a punch. What is this? He throws him into the corner. Randy Orton. Now maybe going for that superplex. Oh. He manages to get Neville at the top rope, but his stamina's low. Oh no, Neville up top the top rope. What is this? A huge drop kick from Neville. Neville, he goes to the top rope, he's going for the red arrow, but what is this? It's an RKO out of nowhere, wow, Randy Orton strikes just like that, out of nowhere. Oh my gosh, Randy Orton. Like I was saying before, that could be a 1, 2, 3, wow, oh my god, wow, okay, Randy Orton, Sean, why is the Apex Predator, the Viper? That was phenomenal. Let's even get a replay on that. Look at this. He goes for the red arrow, but Randy Orton just gets up in the nick of time, catching him in the RKO. Randy Orton just going to the top rope to celebrate that victory. Neville came so close, but at the end of the day, you know, he is the Viper. He is a hardened veteran in this industry. You know, he's been around for a long, long time, since about 2002. So that's a good 8-9 year. I don't know. 8-9 year, what am I talking about? He's been in there for about, what will that be? If he came in 2002, that'd be 14 year, wouldn't it? I would. Wow, 14 year. But anyways, let's get into the main event of the evening. And I will see you all there. Alright, so Lillian Garcia is going to introduce this match. So, here she is, the challenger, the number one contender, Bayley. Now, this could be the last time she gets this opportunity, because remember, after this title opportunity, the next time this title will be getting put on the line will be against the SmackDown Women's Champion. Now, when these belts are merged, that means the competition for the women's division is going to get to a whole new level, because, you know, maybe we'll make some cuts even. Maybe the Divas division might need to be cut down a bit, I don't know. But, you see, now, for the new champion, obviously, they're going to have two number one contenders. So, one of the number one contenders is going to have to be moved down. So, Bayley could just get lost in the mix. This could be the last time she gets this opportunity. I mean, this is the first time she gets the opportunity, to be honest with you. But, anyways, now we're about to introduce the champion, the WWE Women's Champion of Raw. Yeah, she is. Nikki Bella with them dodgy ass leggings on. Yeah, she is women's champion. Making her way to the ring right now. So, I don't know how much competition she's been in. One second, let's just, I'm gonna take a drink. One minute. There we are. Now, I don't know how much in-ring competition she's actually been in. I know she's had a few matches here and there, and she's got the win. So, you know, she's keeping some good momentum going in this match. I think she might actually underestimate Bayley. Now, that's going to be a big issue. People can't underestimate Bayley, because she has been NXT champion. You know? So, it's hard. You know, I mean, she was the last one to be brought up to the main roster, but like I said, you shouldn't underestimate her. She's one of the best in the Divas division today, and we're gonna see if she can pull the upset up tonight as we get straight into this match. We're gonna see if Nikki Bella shows her the respect that she deserves, just kissing the crowd, you know, as they're going straight for the lockup in the center of the ring. But the champion Nikki Bella pushes her straight in the ropes, getting the upper hand. What is this? The referee obviously only got to a 5 count, but Nikki Bella Clean break. Clean break. As you go in front of that tie-up, Nikki Bella. Oh, no. Bailey. Bailey gets the upper hand. Oh, Bailey. Like I said, you can't underestimate Bailey. Look at this technical standpoint of our Bailey. Nikki Bella, obviously, champion's advantage, getting straight into some sort of crossface maneuver. Now Nikki Bella just wrenching on that arm. Now Nikki Bella taunting. But once again, you can't underestimate Bailey as she taunted in the wrong spot, the wrong place, the wrong time. And now, Bailey getting straight into submission. What is this? This could end the match right now. But no. Obviously, Nikki Bella. Nikki Bella may be a little bit off her game tonight. She needs to be the best she can be. Oh, but look. Bailey throwing over the top rope. Go for that huge hit. What is this? Is it a suplex? No. Oh, I was going to say not the outside. Nikki Bella going straight up top. As she calls Bailey to her feet. What could you be looking for? Huge missile dropkick. Wow. Look at the athleticism of Nikki Bella. Oh my god, it feels weird commentating again. I haven't did Universe Mode in a few days. Oh gosh. Huge arm drag from Bailey. Huge jawbreaker. What is this? Snapmare. Into the kick straight to the back. That must echo through the spine of Bailey. What is this? And just another kick to the face. That's really bringing it to Bailey. You know. She's looking very strong style tonight, if I do see so myself. She throws on the corner of Bailey with a boot of her own her face. But the champion rolls up Bailey. The champion rolls up Bailey. That must be it. That must be it. 1, 2. That must be it. No. 2.9. Bailey in a bad position. She got rolled up there, but she did manage to get out. Wow. Nikki Bella almost had the win right there. Huge chop. Woo! From Nikki. I know I shouldn't do that because I have Charlotte sick, but still. Oh, straight back off the rope. What is this? Some sort of flatliner? No, it's not. Some sort of STO variation. She picks her up now. Oh, Bailey starting to fight back. Oh, huge forearm. Maybe starting to show a vicious side, but a jawbreaker. What is this? No. Mini attitude adjustment. Or fireman's carry, whatever. As Bailey starts to target the head, as she starts to gain some momentum in this matchup. Bailey doesn't look like she's in a bad position here, but I mean, she definitely hasn't got the air. I mean, now she's starting to get the upper hand, but the start of the match, she wasn't looking too good against the champ. What is this? That was an Irish whip. Oh, but Nikki Bella just taking out Bailey. If she takes out the outside, can she even make that jump? What? Oh my gosh! Holy, oh my god. Nikki Bella. Just standing Bailey up. What is this? Some sort of huge forearm to the face. Wow. Wow, Bailey is out. Bailey is out. She goes into the cover. That must be it. That's a 2. And that's a 3 right there. No, it's not. Bailey manages to kick out. Amazing. Now, what is this? Nikki Bella's looking for it. It's the torture rack. Is it the rack attack? Can't you hit it? Bailey just, she's just not on her A-game tonight, you know? As Nikki Bella slides straight into the pin, and that must be all. 2. What? Only a 1 count? Only a 1 count? Bailey using that resiliency of hers. Wow. Now Nikki Bella. Maybe taunting? I don't know what this is. She can't let the frustration settle in, though. Because Bailey will capitalize on that as soon as she can. And there we are. We have Bailey in the corner with a huge monkey flip. Wow. A monkey flip. And now Bailey starting to get hype in the corner. But Nikki Bella, she's got to be careful. Nikki Bella is getting back to her feet. What is this? No, what is this? It's a Bailey to Bailey. A Bailey to Bailey in the center of the ring. She goes straight into the pinfall. 1. Only a 1 count, though. Only a 1 count, though. Nikki Bella says, you know what? You kick out my move at 1. Hell, I'll kick out of your move at 1. Wow. Now Bailey's starting to gain some huge momentum in this match. Just kicking away at Nikki Bella. Now what is this? What is this? Oh, huge axe handle. Another huge axe handle. She's getting hype. She throws out in the corner. And that's, oh my gosh. Bailey is on a roll. Like I said, you can't underestimate her. What is this? But it's a reversal from Nikki Bella. Ooh, straight after the back. What is this? Nikki Bella taken out of the top rope, it looks like. Yes, it is. Now Nikki Bella. What is this? She is not looking for this. No, not a superplex. From the top rope. Whoa, from the top rope. Oh my gosh. Remember, Nikki Bella has had a recurring neck injury that could have injured her right there. Now Nikki Bella. Just looking to gain some momentum in this match with a huge backbreaker to Bayley. You know, just really taking it to her. Causing Bayley to have a red body part already. That's pretty insane. Oh, she misses the forearm. What is this? She goes for some sort of RKO maneuver. Bayley just throwing Nikki Bella out in the corner. And now, like I was saying before, she had a reoccurring neck injury. Now, Bayley could be taking her up top for that. Yes, it looks like she's taking her up top to go for that neck. Oh my gosh, a huge hurricanrana from the top rope. Now, Bayley looking to be the one in control in this match. Now, and this is going to be very scary for Nikki Bella, as Bayley is, she's on a roll. But Nikki Bella manages to get up, but no. Bayley manages to reverse, but no, Nikki. What is this? Oh my gosh, the shot in the midsection. Huge Irish whip. Now, ooh, but Nikki Bella just really scrubbing away on the face of Bayley. Nikki Bella calling her a loser. Wow. Wow, I don't know if you should be calling that a loser, but she hits out with that huge drop kick on the side. Nikki Bella picking her up, maybe looking for the end. Ooh, and she hits it. She hits the snap me knee. As she pulls her to the corner of the ring. Now, this could be all she wrote, people. As she goes for a charge finish. She's looking for something here. Maybe another rack attack. And oh my god, she gets out of the rack attack. This is all. Bayley had a good run, you know. She hit out with a Bayley to belly. But sometimes, dreaming about the championship just isn't enough. You really need to put yourself on the line. And maybe in the future she's getting another opportunity. One, two. But no! Bayley kicks out! Wow, now maybe the frustration's starting to set in to Nikki Bella. What is she going to do to put away the challenger? Wow. And now look at this, Bayley. Oh my gosh, Bayley. She throws out in the corner. What is this? What is this? Oh my god, did you see the way Nikki Bella's neck bent? Remember, Nikki Bella's got a neck injury. Nikki Bella had a reoccurring neck injury. Now, Bayley really starting to target that face. Oh my god, that exploder suplex in the corner. Really, it must have just really hurt Nikki Bella's neck. You can see it's just starting to grab her face. Now, Bayley looking for the end. Oh my god, she hits it. The Bayley to belly. She hits the Bayley to belly. One. Two. Oh my gosh. But Nikki Bella. Nikki Bella. Fearlessly kicks out. Wow. Wow. Going straight after that neck one more time. Bayley is looking strong in this matchup. Just dropping the elbow on Nikki Bella. Stamping away on her body parts. Wow. What is this? Oh my gosh. Straight back after the arm again. A stumble on the back of the head. And once again, targeting the head. Just a flurry, a combination of moves. Wow, she's really starting to stamp away on Nikki Bella. Oh my god. I'm scared for Nikki Bella's health. I don't want to stop this match, but I feel as if it goes on like this any longer, I might have to stop the match. Might have to get some referees in here to check on Nikki Bella. I don't want to be that guy, but it doesn't look good for the champ. Look. Oh my god. As the color of her face just starts to darken and Bayley knows. Bayley knows, but I mean, we've got to kick out. Maybe that's just on instinct at this point. You know? I mean, Nikki Bella, she rolls to the outside, but how much more has she got in her? You know? Asia throws Bailey at the outside. She goes for a big kick. Oh my god. Some sort of suplex maneuver on the outside. You know, just stamping on the back of that neck. Remember, Bailey can't win the championship at a count out or disqualification. So Bailey's got to be real careful. If she wants to pin the champ, she needs to get her back in the ring right now. But still, obsessed with the neck. Obsessed with proving a point. But Nikki Bella, she throws her. She throws her into the steel steps. If she gets in the ring, maybe to go. Oh no, she gets on the outside. Nikki Bella doesn't want to end this way. Wow. Now there we are, just returning with that huge elbow. Now, Nikki Bella. What is this? Once again, on that backbreaker. Nikki Bella, I don't know how much... What is she doing? I don't know if going to the top rope is wise in this situation, you know? Going to high-risk territory. Another leg drop! Wow! Okay. Vicious forearm from Nikki Bella. And she just goes to one knee. I don't know how much more she's got left in her. No. She picks her up. What is this? And, ooh. She gets her up in the rack attack once again. She gets her up in the rack attack once again. And she hits it. Wow. And now that is all she wrote, I believe. Bailey with a phenomenal, 2, 3. What? Okay, okay. Oh my gosh. Okay. Bailey. Wow. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. Now Bailey back on the... Now throwing in the cover. But no, only a one count. Wow. I'm lost for words. Wow. Bailey really starting to show why she should be champ in a 5-star match on Raw in the main event. But no, we're getting an Irish whip over here. Just suplexing out the inside. Nikki Bella once again. She keeps her dropping a one knee. Something must be wrong. But Nikki still wants to. You know, she still wants to fight on. Just comboing Bailey. Just strong styling her. Oh, but Bailey. But Bailey. She throws her in the corner. What is this? What could she be looking for? Oh my gosh, what is this? No, not the move that hurt her neck before. And once again, targeting that neck. Wow. Once again, targeting that neck. Nikki Bella. I don't know how much more she's got left. But it's not much. And she takes out the top rope to go for another hurricanrana of some sort. Oh, but Nikki Bella. Nikki Bella finding a way with a huge missile drop kick. Nikki Bella's, you know, she's really trying her hardest here. Just, wow. You can see the frustration in Nikki Bella. You know, just trying to, what's it called? Trying to just inflict damage. She's not even going for the pin at this point, you know. And once again, she calls for the end. What is this? But Bailey, but Bailey, but Bailey. Oh my gosh, but Bailey now with a neck breaker, reversing the rack attack. Now stamping on the neck. But once again, going straight after the neck. Wow. And now what is this? It's Bailey's signature. And she hits her with it. Bailey is getting hype in the corner. I don't know how long Nikki Bella can hold on, to be honest with you. There we are. Bailey calls for the finish. Now I just... Now Bailey taunting, wow. If she throws out the corner, she really wants to go for this hurricanrana. Is she going to hit it? Oh my god. Oh my god. Brie Bella. Brie Bella managing to get out of the way. As she throws Bailey into the ropes. Oh. Now, oh my gosh. Now Nikki Bella. Nikki Bella. Oh my god, Bailey. Bailey gets hit with the belly to back. One. Oh, only a one count. Only a one count. Wow. Nikki Bella. Bailey, dropped on one knee. The frustration is settling in, definitely. You know, we can see it in her face, as we saw there. I don't know how much it's going to take to put away. But she calls for it again. She calls for it one last time. There it is. The Bailey to belly. She hits the Bailey to belly straight into the pin. One. Two, three. Guys, we have a new Raw champion. Bailey. I don't know what that was. That was kind of we just didn't know how long. How long Nikki Bella could hold on, to be honest with you. You know, she hit out with all she had, but Bailey. No, but Bailey really shown. Why can't I talk to her? Bailey really shown that resilient side of her, you know? She's really shown why she should be the champion, rightfully so. Hitting out with two back-to-back Bailey to bellies. That's amazing. That's I believe that's the end of the show. Hope you guys have enjoyed. If you have... Oh, wait, let's go... one sec, I want to go to the news. Let's just exit out of here. Wow, that was a good match, though. That was a good match. I'm happy with that. You know, the new era has really taken over with the current champions. So, it means next payback, it's going to be Asuka versus Bayley for the undisputed title. That's going to be crazy, right? These are all the extra matches that they added. Just because when you add matches on universe mode, sometimes they add extra ones because it's glitched. So yeah, let's just back out of that. Oh god, that was actually pretty good. And I don't know how long this episode's been going on for. I'd assume quite a long time, but still. Oh wow, actually, we need to... Wow, okay, so we need to actually simulate their matches to go on to the news. Okay, I mean, whatever. I guess I'll just go simulate them quickly. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, I wish it wouldn't take so long. I need to fucking edit this video and render it. No, I don't want to play them out right. Okay, guys, so if you've enjoyed this episode, go ahead and leave a like button down below. And if you haven't already subscribed, go subscribe. And yeah, I hope you guys have a fantastic day. And I'll see you all in the next episode. Okay, goodbye.